CEO Elon Musk claims that SpaceX could be ready to attempt Starship's first orbital launch as early as July. While SpaceX has been making slow and steady progress, preparing the Starship upper stage and Super Heavy booster nominally assigned to that launch debut. The odds that even just one of those two stages will be fully qualified for flight before the end of July are quite small. Musk's claims about what will happen after that rocket is ready are even loftier. According to Musk, after SpaceX is done preparing a Starship and Super Heavy booster for their inaugural orbital launch attempt sometime next month, the company will have a second ship and booster pair ready to fly in August, and another pair every month after that. If SpaceX rapidly completes the dozens of environmental mitigations assigned to it on June 13, and receives an FAA license, or experimental permit for orbital Starship launches, the company does theoretically have permission for 5 orbital launches out of South Texas in 2022, but the same is also true for all 12 months of 2023. However, there is very little evidence that SpaceX is on the cusp of being able to complete a new orbital class Starship and Super Heavy booster every month. While SpaceX is working on future Starships and is almost done assembling a second orbital class Super Heavy booster, the pace of that work appears to be about the same as it's been for the last 12 plus months. Yes, SpaceX is almost done stacking booster 8 and has begun stacking ship 25. Sections of ship 26, ship 27, and booster 9 have also been spotted at Starbase. But SpaceX has been unable to finish stacking booster 8. Over the last few months, it's been focused on ship 24 and booster 7. Ship 24 and Booster 7, meanwhile, are making good progress but are still incomplete. Both recently completed several mostly successful cryogenic and structural proof tests, and returned to SpaceX's assembly bays, where workers have begun installing Raptor engines and applying finishing touches. After a month of work, it appears that Super Heavy B7 may finally be preparing to return to Starbase's launch site on Thursday, June 16. Since it returned to the factory on May 14, SpaceX has been installing 33 new Raptor 2 engines, applying thermal protection to those engines, buttoning up the booster's aft end, installing control surfaces known as grid fins, and completing a few other unfinished tasks. If all of that work is complete when it rolls out again, B7 could kick off the next phase of its qualification testing, wet dress rehearsals and static fires, shortly after returning to the orbital launch site. SpaceX has never attempted a full-scale Super Heavy wet dress rehearsal, in which the largest rocket booster ever built will be fully filled with more than 3,000 metric tons of flammable cryogenic propellant and put through a simulated launch countdown. SpaceX has also never come close to conducting a full Super Heavy static fire, though it did fire 3 outdated Raptors on an outdated booster prototype a single time in July 2021. Ship 24's position is slightly more favorable, as it only needs 6 Raptor 2 engines installed. Thanks to Ship 20, which successfully completed several wet dress rehearsals and several static fires that ignited all 6 engines, Ship 24 will also be heading into terrain that is slightly less uncharted. Still, the Starship's heat shield needs several hundred more tiles installed, one of 4 flap aerocover caps is missing, and thermal protection will need to be installed around its Raptors. Once Booster 7 and Ship 24 are both fully outfitted and installed on their respective test stands, there's still little reason to believe that either prototype has any chance of completing all the tests needed for flight qualification by the end of July. In fact, for B7 and S24 to be truly ready for flight before the end of July, they'd likely need to wrap up qualification testing well before the end of the month to conduct another series of tests after the pair is fully stacked. If SpaceX does not proceed with at least some degree of caution and a plan to thoroughly test both stages before a launch attempt, it will significantly increase the risk of catastrophic launch pad damage that could easily take half a year or more to fix. More realistically, it's reasonable to assume that Ship 24 and Booster 7 will both run into some minor issues during their first wet dress rehearsals and static fire tests, possibly requiring Raptor replacements or even minor repairs. Instead of a few weeks, serious flight qualification could take a few months. It's also arguably far likelier that one or both stages will need to be entirely replaced by Ship 25 or Booster 8 than it is that both will be ready to launch 6 weeks from now. Both Booster 4 and Ship 24 suffered some degree of damage, during proof tests that are in many ways much easier than the wet dress, and static fire tests they'll soon face. Still, despite the many reasons for pragmatism and expectation management, SpaceX has never been closer to Starship's orbital launch debut, and the odds of that debut occurring sometime in 2022 have never been better. And lastly, after many hurdles, finally SpaceX has secured environmental approval from the FAA and relevant federal, state, and local stakeholders to conduct orbital Starship launches on the South Texas coast. After a relatively normal 12 months of work, and half a dozen poorly communicated delays, the FAA has ultimately issued SpaceX an extremely favorable, mitigated finding of no significant impact. OR mitigated FONSI for its plans to conduct a very limited number of orbital Starship launches per year out of Boca Chica, Texas. With the receipt of that final programmatic environmental assessment, SpaceX has arguably hurdled the most difficult regulatory barrier for Texas orbital Starship launches. SpaceX secured itself a foundation, upon which it should be able to attempt to expand the scope of Starbases for long-term utility. To secure that favorable result, however, SpaceX ultimately agreed to dozens upon dozens of mitigations. That will take a significant amount of work to complete and maintain in order to partially alleviate some of the launch site's environmental impact. It's also far from the last regulatory hurdle standing between SpaceX and orbital Starship launches. In many ways, Starbase's final P is a bit simpler than what SpaceX initially requested in its September 2021 draft. As previously discussed, it was already known that SpaceX had withdrawn initial plans to build its own dedicated natural gas power plant, desalination plant, and natural gas refinery, and liquefaction facilities at or near the launch site, before the draft was finalized. The final P goes a bit further, simplifying SpaceX's initial request for two phases of annual Starship launch operations, and settling on a single operational phase that allows up to 5 suborbital and 5 orbital Starship launches per year. However, aside from the already expected removal of on-site methane fuel production and all associated facilities, the rest of the final P appears to be surprisingly close, if not outright identical, to SpaceX's Starbase draft P. Crucially, SpaceX was not forced to reduce the number of permitted orbital launches, suborbital launches, or ship booster static fire tests it originally pursued. While a maximum of 5 orbital launches will severely limit Starbase's utility outside of early flight testing, it's still a big improvement over a compromise for 1-4 annual launches. Perhaps even more notably, the final P also includes permission for up to 500 hours of highway closures for nominal operations, and up to 300 hours of closures for emergency anomaly response per year. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.